Coming up on News Live at 6, another favorite student tradition is adapting to COVID-19. Find out how University Union is safely working to safely host Mayfest.
Plus, the university is changing how student food funds work. We'll break down the changes coming to SU dining halls.
And Marshall Street is preparing for when students leave campus over the summer. CitrusTV reporter Teagan Brown spoke with multiple business owners about their plans. All that and more, CitrusTV News Live at 6 starts right now.
This news leader.
In its final week, Syracuse University is seeing a drop in COVID-19 cases on campus, the lowest since early October. Good evening, I'm Liam Crowley.
And I'm Ricky Sayer. Cases are inching toward zero. There are currently only 4 active cases on campus and 1 away from Central New York. This is good news for SU events next semester, but it does not come soon enough. Friday is Syracuse University's annual block party. CitrusTV reporter Sammy Lindell is at Walnut Park. Sammy, tell us what happens at Walnut Park in a normal year.
Thanks, guys. Block party would usually take place right here in Walnut Park. However, this year this concert is being held virtually, and there are some in-person events on campus.
Block Party is taking place this weekend at Syracuse University and is an event that is organized by University Union, which is entirely student-run. The team works to put on large-scale concert events to keep campus entertained. There will be a virtual performance with well-known artists this Friday, May 14th.
In a normal year, Block Party is a concert event that usually consists of like 2 or 3 artists in the Carrier Dome.
Switching from an in-person to a virtual setting has been no easy task for those running it.
Throughout the school year, we've sort of been learning how to work in a virtual setting by having live stream performances and, getting used to and learning all of that technology and really just making it the best it can be for the students.
So in terms of activations, we've really tried to enhance viewing at home. A few things we've done is like pre-show trivia from people's homes, and we give away things on our Instagram story. We also do brand partnerships over our story. So that's really how our role has changed, just kind of adapting to at-home activations.
Aside from the live stream performance, there will also be activities on the quad for students to enjoy.
So on the quad, we're gonna have a signing canvas. We're gonna have a brand tabling, HBO Max. We're going to have a tie-dye station, a photo booth. At the Women's Building, we're having a silent disco featuring a virtual set from Snake Hips and like a virtual car racing activity. The reason why we kind of wanted to have those in person is just to feel more like an Orange family. We want to have an in-person component, feel like people are able to celebrate. It's the end of the year, more people are being vaccinated, and we have the bandwidth to make it a safe activation, I guess.
You can RSVP for these events on University Union's Instagram page by clicking the link in the bio. I'm Sammy Lindell, CitrusTV News.
Sammy, thank you. Happening now in person, pet therapy has finally returned to campus. The Barnes Center is holding a special pet therapy event right now at the HBC patio until 6:45. All SU and SUNY ESF students are encouraged to join to relieve some stress as the semester winds down.
Syracuse University is set to renovate multiple buildings along Waverly Avenue. Pete Sala announced today that the exterior of the Shine Student Center along Waverly will get an upgrade.
The north entrance to Byrd Library is also set to receive some renovations. Shine renovations will conclude at the start of fall classes, but there is currently no word on Byrd Library's timetable.
New details on 2021's delayed tax day. The deadline to file taxes is Monday. SU is trying to assist students who still need to file this afternoon. The Office of Financial Literacy offered 30-minute tax sessions for students, faculty, and staff to file their taxes free of charge. They are offering 2 more sessions tomorrow. You can register online through the wellness portal.
Along with the announced changes to meal plans and laundry services, changes are also coming to SU Supercard. Here to tell us what's adjusting to SU Supercard is CitrusTV reporter Bradley Hoppenstein.
Thanks, Liam. So SU's transitioning its Supercard into an all-in-one campus cash option. Supercard and Food Plus will merge into QS Cash, but let's take a look at all the changes and some student reaction. With a redesign coming to Syracuse meal plans and pricing next year, SU's Supercard is also getting a fresh coat of paint in the form of CUSE Cash. Beginning July 6th, funds from Supercard Food and Plus accounts will be merged into a new single option called CUSE Cash. For the Housing and Meal Plan website, CUSE Cash can be used at nearly every point of sale on campus.
I don't think it's going to make that much of a difference. I think you still have the same amount of money on there.
Well, for me, I really like the way the Supercard's been, just because it's been a really easy way.
I mean, it seems like it might be something we can get used to pretty quickly, but I don't know. Maybe I just don't like change.
But there is a bit of confusion with the new meal plans and pricing, with SU's dining dollars actually not going away either. But where students were formerly able to replenish those dining dollars, now the only way a student can get dining dollars is to purchase a meal plan that comes with them. Once that money is gone, students can then only add funds to the new CUSE Cash option.
I think it's a good idea to have all your cash under one like CUSE Cash thing, but I don't think that dining dollars and CUSE Cash should be separate.
It's just not that clear to me. I don't really see the benefit in doing that.
It's confusing to me now, but as long as I can access all my money on one swipe, I think it'll be okay.
CUSE Cash account balances will carry over from fall to spring semesters, but not year to year. However, funds for faculty and staff accounts will roll over into the following year.
I guess it sort of depends on, I don't know, if it makes maybe some administrators' lives a little bit easier. I mean, it seems like it might be something we can get used to pretty quickly.
Students were able to begin to sign up for meal plans for the 2021 school year May 10th. With most meal plans, students will get some dining dollars, but it will be each student's responsibility to add money to the CUSE Cash option if they plan on using it. And even though student accounts won't roll over from year to year, after commencement day, any unused CUSE Cash funds will be credited back to students' bursar accounts. Ricky?
Thank you, Bradley. It was another nice day outside, a great day to just be outside in general. Liam, were you able to take advantage?
Absolutely. The sunny skies were definitely appreciated. No precipitation like we've seen in recent days. And hopefully we see more sunny skies as the week continues. Peyton, what can you tell us?
Yes, you guys, we have been experiencing some super nice weather recently. I'm from California, so last week I was hoping to go home, get that nice weather back, but now the weather is all nice again, so I kind of want to stay. Right now it's 62 degrees and sunny skies, not too much wind, about 20 miles per hour winds, but everything's looking pretty light. Now looking into tonight, it's going to be 52 degrees, so not that cold. There's going to be a few passing clouds, but all around some clear skies. That's all I have for you guys right now. Back to you.
Peyton, thank you. Students are preparing to return home for the summer, but what does that mean for businesses who depend on students as consumers? Our correspondent Teagan Brown spoke with owners and employees on Marshall Street about changes they face in the summer. Teagan?
I'm standing here on Marshall Street, where on any given day, you will see hundreds of students going in and out of stores and restaurants. But with only about a week of classes and finals left, SU students will be leaving and these businesses will lose their main audience. I spoke with some of the popular destinations on the street to learn how they adapt during the summer.
Students make up the majority of those found on Marshall Street. But what happens when that group goes home for the summer? Varsity co-owner Jerry Dellis spoke about his business's experience.
Typically, summers are a lot slower. We're only open Monday through Friday.
Years ago, before Syracuse gained so many other commercial areas and venues, the community would come to Marshall Street at all times of the year.
The university area was the hot spot. There was no Armory Square, there was no Hanover Square, there was the mall was here, but you know, we used to do almost as much business during the summer as we did during the school year.
During a normal year, Marshall Street is usually bustling with activity due to dome events and students being on campus. But during the summer, that is just not the case. At J. Michael Shoes, manager Eric Hicks has worked here long enough to know that businesses must adapt during the summer.
We plan for this type of thing. But there's a reason that you see a lot of turnover with stores on Marshall Street, with the mom and pops anyway, because you have to learn how to plan a budget for the downtime.
Since there are no students here during the summer to act as consumers, this also means there are no students to be hired as employees.
They go home for the breaks, so they're not here to work, so I don't have to worry about giving them hours, you know, so kind of works well that way.
Although it may look emptier during the warm season, students will return to their usual shopping and eating destination in the fall.
For CitrusTV News, I'm Teagan Brown.
While part of the Syracuse community comes down here during the summer, businesses are hoping more will make the drive or walk down to Marshall Street. Guys, back to you.
Thank you, Teagan. The New York State Food Fest is adding new attractions this weekend. The event will for the first time feature a full carnival. There'll be rides and games. That's on top of the standard corn dogs, funnel cakes, and frozen lemonade. The fair will be open from Friday to Sunday from 11 a.m. to 8 p.m. at the fairgrounds.
Ricky, it definitely looked like you had a great time in past years. But coming up, Republicans in the House voted to remove Representative Liz Cheney as chair of the House Republican Conference. Find out how this could impact the future of the party.
Lumber and gas prices are on the rise. How two unfortunate events impacted these industries when we come back.
Bedroom. Come on, come on. Okay, Dad. One, two, three. Dad! You saved me. Dad?
Are you okay?
I'm fine, dear.
Your hero needs you now, and AARP is here to help. Find the care guides you need at aarp.org/caregiving.
Your girls have been with you through every moment of your life. They were with you when you felt unbreakable. With you that time you felt most alone. And with you when you realized you would never be. They were with you when you shared your love with the world. And with you when she became your world. Your girls have never left you. They're still with you right now. But how well do you know them?
You don't know my
Knowing your breasts can save your life.
You're watching Citrus TV News with Ricky Sayer, Oscar Offerman, Liam Crowley, Peyton Spellacy, Bradley Hoppenstein, and Samantha Lindell. Citrus TV News, your campus news leader.
Welcome back to News Live at 6. The COVID-19 vaccine has another seal of approval. Federal health officials today endorsed Pfizer's vaccine for kids 12 to 16. This opens the doors for states to ship doses right to pediatricians and, in some cases, schools themselves.
A top Republican is out of a leadership post this evening. Republicans in the House voted in a closed-door session to remove Representative Liz Cheney from her leadership position as chair of the House Republican Conference. She was the third highest-ranking Republican in the House.
Cheney was one of only 10 Republicans in the House to vote to impeach former President Donald Trump after the events of January 6th. She has been outspoken against the former president since those events, which turned many Republicans against her. And this just into our newsroom, the Colonial Pipeline is back online after a cyber attack. However, it will still take several days for the supply to return to normal. Many southern states have been dealing with major gas shortages after the cyber attack cut off the gas supply. Gas prices in many states along the pipeline's route, which stretches from Texas to New Jersey, have been rising sharply.
The attack was carried out by a Russian group known as Dark Side. The average price of gas in the United States is now officially above $3 per gallon for the first time in 7 years.
And also increasing in prices, lumber. If you're looking to buy a new home, you may be shocked at the soaring price tag. Citrus TV reporter Ryan Baker tells us why.
The housing market is booming, but the price of lumber is more expensive than ever before.
An analysis by the National Association of Home Builders found that soaring lumber prices have increased the average cost of a single-family home by $35,872. Luke Edelstein is a former employee of Northeast Building Supply, where he saw firsthand how the pandemic affected customers.
So we'd have customers come in, contractors, they'd be looking for, you know, all sorts of boards for their clients, and we simply had to tell them either we don't have it, or you can go try another lumber yard, but the price is maybe four times what it normally is, because, you know, as soon as we would get a shipment in from one of our vendors, we would be sold out of it within the next 2 days.
Most workers in the wood industry expected a slowdown during the COVID-19 pandemic, but the exact opposite happened. As people spent more time at home, the demand for home improvement projects soared. Olivia Bon Jovi worked as a Lowe's cashier at the beginning of last summer and says she was surprised at how much people were willing to pay for lumber.
There was way more sort of contractor sales typically than just normal people going in and buying whatever. And I do remember a couple times like ringing up what seemed to me like not that many pieces, and it was like over $1,000. I'm like, you couldn't build anything with this.
The wood products industry tracking firm Random Lengths says that lumber prices have increased 340% from just 1 year ago.
There are a few other products you can go to build decks and things like that. But a lot of people were coming in, they were still buying the boards, even if they were warped or, you know, not as pristine as they would normally only buy them. But, you know, that was the only option they had.
As prices for lumber keep rising, people are still willing to pay, and the demand is simply outpacing supply. Ryan Baker, Citrus TV News.
Ryan, thank you. Rocket fire continues in Israel and Gaza. At least 48 people have been killed in Gaza and 5 in Israel as tensions escalate. The Palestinian militant group Hamas has fired over 1,000 rockets into Israel, but many were intercepted.
Israel responded with targeted airstrikes in Gaza, including taking down a high-rise in Gaza City after it had been evacuated. United Nations and other global organizations are calling for a ceasefire.
Will sunny skies stick around for the weekend? I'll let you know when we come back.
They call me Maxie, but I prefer tripod. I was your above-average four-legged homie, and then wham-bam minivan. Some people pity me. Now that's lame. I still run, fetch, and swim. And the ladies love me. I'm the ultimate wingman. Just don't ask me to high-five.
From the Citrus TV Weather Center, this is SU's most accurate weather forecast.
Hello and welcome back to your weather. Right now we are looking at the current temperatures in the area. Like I said earlier, Syracuse is 62, looking at some pretty similar temperatures down there in Ithaca, Elmira, Pinion, Rochester, Rome. Rochester actually had a really nice day today. It was in the 70s, a high 70s too. And they're looking to have a nice day tomorrow, just like here in Syracuse. Now taking a closer look at tomorrow and the rest of the week, we have Thursday and Friday is going to be very sunny. So look forward to that because it's going to be 66 tomorrow. That's about 10 degrees hotter than it was today. 70 on Friday with a low of 40s. And then on Saturday, we're going to see some clouds, partially cloudy, but don't you worry, because on Sunday and Monday, some of those clouds are going to go away, and we're going to see some more of that sun. And we're reaching up to the 70s like we are on Friday. So all around, it's going to be a really nice week. So make sure to grab those shorts and get outside, get some lunch on the quad, and just hang out in the nice sun. Now taking a closer look at tomorrow, at 8 a.m., it's going to be a little cold. It's going to be in the 50s, or 48 to be specific. At noon, though, it's going to jump into the 60s. So it's going to be all around a nice day. Will, what can we expect in sports?
Coming up, I'm going to break down what went wrong for the softball team in Louisville. Plus, we got some Mets baseball going on today, and I'll break down the NBA playoff race. Stay tuned.
I see you mobbing over her. Let's go. Let's mob. Let's crawl. Let's crawl. Let's crawl. Hey, yo, we mobbing. Come on, girl. Let's crawl. Hey, yo, let's crawl. Hey, yo, let's crawl. Hey, let's crawl. Hey, yo, let's crawl.
Looking for these? You drive buzzed, it could be one very expensive ride.
First, you gotta make bail. Then pay me to get your car back.
Your insurance premiums will go through the roof.
And my legal fees just keep adding up. All told, it could end up costing you $10,000.
Buzzed, busted, and broke. Because buzz driving is drunk driving.
Now, your CitrusTV Sports Report.
Welcome to sports. I'm Will Scott. Well, it was a quick trip to Louisville for the Syracuse softball team. Earlier today, the eighth-seeded Orange were no-hit by Georgia Tech and eliminated from the ACC tournament. Blake Nelman had the best start of her career, the freshman tossing 9 strikeouts in a no-hitter. A hit batter was the only thing that kept her from a perfect game. In the last game of her Syracuse career, Alexa Romero gave it all she had, but a 5-run sixth inning killed the Orange's chances. The Jackets advance to face top-seeded Clemson tomorrow. Syracuse finishes their 2021 campaign with a 20-24 record. Moving to baseball, the Mets improved to 18-13 today with a 7-1 win over the Baltimore Orioles at Citi Field. Taijuan Walker threw a gem. 7 strong innings, giving up just 1 run on 4 hits with 4 strikeouts. Dominic Smith led the way for the Amazons, going 3-for-4 with a double and 2 RBIs. The Mets add another game to their NL East lead. It's now 2 games over the Phillies for first place. The victory also secures a 2-game sweep over the Orioles for New York. They have won 7 straight games and head to Tampa for a 3-game weekend set against the Rays. Well, speaking of the Rays, the Yankees will be looking for their 4th straight win tonight when they take on Tampa. And Garrett Cole, who has the ball tonight for New York, will be looking for his first ever win against the Rays. He has a career record of 0-4 against Tampa Bay. He's having a phenomenal season, though, for New York. In 7 starts, he's 4-1 with a 1.61 ERA. He's going up tonight against his former Astros teammate in Colin McHugh, who gets the start for the Rays. New York, who won last night 3-1, can clinch the series with a win tonight. First pitch is set for 7:10. And major playoff implications on the line tonight in the NBA when the Spurs meet the Nets in Brooklyn. The Nets are just one game up on Milwaukee for the third seed in the East and still have an outside chance at jumping Philly for the one seed. Out west, San Antonio leads the Pelicans by 2.5 games for the last play-in game spot. With a win tonight over Brooklyn plus a New Orleans loss to Dallas, the Spurs would clinch a play-in game spot. And the Nets might be without Kyrie Irving tonight, who suffered a facial contusion in yesterday's win over Chicago. But the good news, James Harden might be back. The Beard has missed 18 straight games with a hamstring injury. Tip-off from the Barclays Center is at 8 o'clock tonight. And speaking of the playoffs, Liam, with your Celtics likely having to participate in the play-in tournament, a first-round matchup with Ricky Sixers, that's very possible.
It is very possible, and I'd like to get your quick thoughts. Who's coming out of that series if it happens?
I think I got to go with the upset. The Celtics have not been able to put it together all year, but all it takes is a couple good games against Philadelphia. And Ricky, all due respect, the Sixers are kind of choking the playoffs the last couple years.
Thanks, we'll be right back.
Cause a wildfire.
Hey guys, it's Smokey.
It looks as if Smokey is going to use the drown, stir, drown, and feel technique. After the first drown, a good stir. Next, another drink. Next, and finally, a close feel.
Is it cool? Okay.
Yeah.
Hey Smokey, catch.
Oh. My bad, Smokey.
Only you can prevent wildfires.
Superheroes?
Just four brothers who hate bullies and love this city.
Taking one last look at your wake-up weather, it is going to be 48 degrees tomorrow morning at around 8 a.m. Now, that's all I have for you. Back to you guys.
Thanks. Before we go, we want to take a moment to thank the senior members of Wednesday News here at Citrus TV. We couldn't have done it without you.
We very much appreciate your dedication and guidance throughout a very challenging year. On your screen, you can now see some photos of our senior members here today. Kicking things off, we got so many people there. We got Caitlin, we got Will, Carmella, and Josh all together on screen. Eric Moon down south in Virginia covering some Syracuse basketball. What great senior members.
They have really all meant the world to us here at Citrus TV.
And Michael Frenari, AP today, anchor other days as well, talking points. So many shows Frenari has appeared on over the years.
Always pulling in the work, and it's really great to see all the work that they've done this all these 4 years. We thank them so much. Oh, look, all the seniors that we had here today. Frenari, not there. Carmella, Josh, Caitlin, as well as Will. I'm going to miss so much about them. You know, Will's my guy. Great to talk to him about sports there in the sports chat. Caitlin, such a close friend. Josh, we haven't known each other for too long, but you've been a great producer of the Now there.
And Carmella as well. She appears in so many shows on screen, but she does just as much work behind the scenes that you don't get to see on screen. Caitlin, obviously editing so much for sports, editing so much for news, TDing today as well. She does it all. Every one of these members wears so many hats behind the scenes.
And our lifetime achievement winner too, Caitlin.
Caitlin Alsop, an invaluable member of Citrus TV. Everyone, we're going to miss them so much. But that's all the time we have on Citrus TV News Live at 6 tonight. For the latest, be sure to follow us on Twitter and Instagram at Citrus TV News. And be sure to like us on Facebook. I'm Liam Crowley.
And I'm Ricky Sayer. For all of us here at Citrus TV, have a great evening and an even better tomorrow.